can say balance is stagnant, because the rule of nature is if something doesn't change, it
doesn't want to change.
If something doesn't grow, it is not settled, it is perishing actually. You know, there is no state of settlement in nature. Security or not security, what is that? Settlement is actually stagnant. If the water doesn't flow and you collect the water, what happens to the water? So what is not growing is actually coming back. That time the trolley will not move on its own. So people who ride like this will have a very settled kind of mindset. You know, I'm just settled here. I just don't want to climb any mountains, don't want to reach heights, don't want to be, you know, having more challenges in life, achieving something, solving something, don't want to go there. So the handwriting is straight, it's settled. Now when the trolley is coming down, you know, who has the control?
The trolley.
The trolley, right? So people who ride like this actually, they don't have the control of their life. Life has control over them, you know? So they are just going where life is taking them. It's like a fall from the mountain. So imagine it, just by this 2, 3, 4 informations, what kind of understanding you can know about persons?
So last one is suicide.
Depression. It starts with depression.
Or it's carried away.
It's carried away. When you get carried away, when you don't have control. And when you're getting carried away, you lose hope. So these people are more, have a lot of hope. These people have less hope. You see all the suicide notes here after, you know. If you can see any that, sometimes they are printed in the newspaper. All the handwriting will be down.
Suicide
notes. I tell you one tip, you know. I can make you detective in 5 minutes. If you ever see a suicide note, you know, and it is more than 5 lines, that is not the real suicide.
Why?
Think. If a suicide note is more than 5 sentences,
with the person,
it is not authentic.
The person who commits suicide, he doesn't have any life option, so he doesn't want to write anything.
No, he can grieve about his past also.
See, it's an impulsive movement.
Yes.
See, it doesn't take time to elaborate.
Exactly.
So he has to be within 1 or 2 lines.
Right, perfectly. So if you write more than 3 or 4 sentences, that means your logic is on. And when your logic is on.
Suppose he is frustrated and he wants to just remove everything from his mind and then suicide, then it may be more.
The moment you remove it from his mind, he'll cancel suicide. Because he'll feel better. Right? And the quantity of that frustration is not very high. That, you know, it's such a quantity which can be removed. But a genuine person who wants to commit suicide can't write 2 pages of essay and then commit suicide, impossible. Because to write 2 pages, you need to think rationally.
You change his mind. You change his mind after writing.
Absolutely. So if you know somebody else who commits suicide, request him, just write 2 pages, then do it.
Part of the
person. Unless he's pushed, he'll not. Yeah, somebody tell him.
No, I say part of counseling.
Yeah, part of. Absolutely part of. So, now this is graphology. Okay, the second part is graphotherapy. In psychology, most of the time the solution is that unless you realize what is happening to you, you know, you will not change it. You know, realization is the only solution. You should realize that you are doing this. You should realize that you have temper. You should realize that you are thinking negative. And once you realize, then it will vanish or it will perish. That is the procedure in psychology. That the reason psychological treatments are very long. If you go for a counseling, you have to go minimum 2 years. You know, if the issue is really high. So changing the habit is very difficult. Changing the habit is what? Changing the way you think. What is changing the habit? Like you have a habit of thinking negative. So if I tell you no, don't think negative, just start thinking positive. Is it going to work? No, right? Because I have to change the way you think. It's actually the internal wiring. Like if this switch is connected to this lamp, you know, whenever I click this switch, this lamp is going to be on. You know, it's the programming done inside. Like if I tell you now, don't think of the elephant. What is going to happen?
Start thinking about it.
Yeah, you only think of element and nothing else. No? So, how do you bring up that change in the way you are thinking? It's something called as graphotherapy, where if you change the way you write, you start changing the way you think. Okay. Little difficult to accept, little, you know, weird, sounds very weird. But take this example, if I paint your bedroom black, totally black, and I tell you to stay in that house for 6 months, what will happen? What will happen?
Dark thoughts will come in my mind.
You will write a four-line letter board. There is no four-line one. So, what the, this is an extreme example to tell you, external things start affecting you. External things start affecting you subconsciously. Now, even a complicated signature is an external thing. If you keep doing a complicated thing, you are programming your mind to think in a complicated way all the time. And if you start signing in a very simple manner, you are actually, there is something called a reverse psychology, where you start relating to simple things. I know half of my energy is actually going into make people believe that this is possible. But it's so unnatural to believe, you know, that if you change your handwriting, you know, you'll start. Actually, you know, if you have a handwriting like this, any like this, observe. And if you start writing like this, you know, it will change your state of mind immediately. You just push here. In psychology, they call action beats depression. You know, if you're depressed and you tell somebody to just run 10 kilometers, you know, he'll not know how to get depressed. So action beats depression. It's a chemical reaction in the mind. All the moods, all the habits, all the thoughts are basically a chemical formation in the mind. So this activity has actually changed that chemical formation in the mind. Any queries you have till now?
You mean the chemical formation in the brain?
Right. Yeah.
So you mean the brain is the same as mind or it is different?
Brain is the hardware, mind is the software.
Brain.
I don't know. Yes.
Can it cure shyness?
Can it?
Cure shyness.
Shyness? Definitely.
Shyness.
Oh. Shyness or shyness?
Shyness.
Shyness. Shyness.
Not silent.
Then a person can't sign. They say that some incredible. I don't know. How do you correlate the mind with the
not talkative?
You can't.
Direct.
I'll answer that.
Not talkative.
Who?
I have no mind to be. A person who has got some incredible can't sign because he's not educated. But even then, he has a mind, he has a behavior, he has a empathy, everything possible in the brain chemistry. So how do we correlate? It is zero signature.
No, it is not zero signature.
It means only no signature.
It is beyond the scope of graphology. If you tell me that you are a doctor, but you can't see, you can't listen, and you can't talk, that doesn't mean you are not intelligent. But I can't come to you as a doctor. So, you know, if I go to a client and he says, I can't write, so I say, I can't help. Not useless. I mean, there could be some other science which will help that. One science is not a solution for everything, right? That's the reason we are having a tool of science. So, if you have to analyze a person who can't write, you can't analyze.
So, how do we analyze a person who has different handwritings at different times?
I love that. Before that, you said?
Shyness.
How to cure.
So, if you have to cure shyness, what is the trait you want in you? What is the opposite of that?
Expressive.
Expressive, right? Great. You understand body language to a certain extent? What is body language? Now there are certain people who write like this. Okay? There are certain people who write like this. And there are certain people. Right? In body language, if you see that if you are leaning back and talking, you know, what is the attitude you are putting on?
Casual.
Casual. And
authority.
Relax.
Relax. And